Welcome to Port Blair, the capital of the Andaman, a tropical paradise known for its crystal clear waters and white sandy beaches. In this video, we will take you through a three-day itinerary of the best things to see and do in Port Blair, including where to stay, where to eat, and how much it will cost. When it comes to accommodation, Port Blair has a wide range of options to suit all budgets. For a budget-friendly option, consider staying at the Hotel Blue Bridge or Salt Life or Island Cliff. They all offer comfortable rooms at around 1500 to 2000 rupees per night. For a more luxurious experience, your options are Sinclair's Bayview, Seashell Port Blair and Sea Hills Hotels and Resort. These resorts offer comfortable rooms with modern amenities at around 5,000 to 8,000 rupees per night. Port Blair has a wide range of restaurants that offer a variety of cuisines, from local seafood to international dishes. Our best recommendation are Seafood Delights and Amia. Seafood Delights has a view of Phoenix Bay Jetty and offers one of the best seafood dishes in the area. Amia is part of Seashell and has beautiful rooftop seating. Day 1 of your itinerary should start with a visit to the Cellular Jail National Memorial, a historical site that tells the story of the Indian freedom struggle. The entry fee is 30 rupees for Indian citizens and 500 rupees for foreign tourists. The jail was used by the British to imprison Indian freedom fighters during the colonial era. The jail has been turned into a museum and visitors can take a guided tour to learn more about the history. After visiting the Cellular Jail, head to the Samudrika Marine Museum, which showcases the marine life and geography of the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. The museum features a wide range of marine specimens including shells, corals, and fish, as well as information on the geology. In the afternoon, head to the Corbin's Cove Beach for a sunset walk, or take a boat ride to watch the sunset over the sea. Start your second day early with a ferry ride to Ross Island, which was once the administrative headquarters of the British in the Andamans. The island is a popular spot for history buffs, as it features several British-era buildings and ruins, including a church, a bazaar, and a cemetery. Visitors can take a guided tour to learn more about the island's history, or explore on their own. There is a scenic lighthouse at the other end of the island which offers breathtaking views of the island. The ferry ride costs around 150 rupees for Indian citizens and 600 rupees for foreign tourists. Start your day 3 with a visit to Chidiya Tapu, which is a small coastal village located on the southern tip of South Andaman Island. It is well known for its beautiful beaches, mangroves, and bird-watching opportunities. After reaching Chidiya Tapu, visit the Munda Peher Beach. The beach has several postcard photo opportunities and ample shades to just sit back and relax. The beach is also very popular for sunset. Take a walk through the mangrove forest in Chidiya Tapu, which is home to a wide variety of birds and wildlife. You can also hire a guide to take you on a bird-watching trail of the area. After the forest, head to the Chidiya Tapu Biological Park, which is home to a wide variety of animals and plants. The park has a butterfly conservatory and an orchid house, which are popular among visitors. We suggest you visit Havelock and Neil first and keep at least one day from your Port Blair itinerary to end your tour, as you need to come back to Port Blair to catch your flight or ferry. And that concludes our three-day itinerary for Port Blair and nearby islands. We hope this video has given you a good idea of what to see and do in Port Blair and that it will help you plan your own trip. Thank you for watching and we hope you have a great time.